Here's the people, right? Talk to them.
Yes, peoples. It's week 24, is it?
No, actually it's 23. I announced it wrong last week. But I edited out my incorrect announcement. This is 23.
Now you're messing my head up. Okay.
This is 23.
Week 23, and it's Thanksgiving night at 10:30, and Mike and I are here.
Why are we here?
Because we have no...
No, that's not why we're here. I mean, that might be.
Well, we're here to do the week 23.
We're here for you people.
Yeah, and week 23 is the playfield swap video, and it's approved, so we're going to go over some basic things that you do to start doing a job like this. And there's first primary steps to do, and as well as the show.
Okay. So the overview of what you just said was we did get the green light to go ahead and do the taxi.
Right.
With a couple of exceptions.
We've done enough of these, so we're going to show people how to do it.
Okay.
We've done enough.
We have.
I don't want
to... We've done too many.
Yeah, I don't want...
we're not doing the display on this.
Okay.
We're going to leave that old, what's left of that display in there. And then we'll replace his driver board when that... when the display takes it out.
It will.
We are not doing LEDs on it. He does not want LEDs.
He's not a fan.
That's
he likes backbox LEDs. He likes that, but he doesn't like playfield.
Okay, well, no LEDs on this.
I don't feel either way about it. I don't care what anybody really likes or don't like about them. I like them because they're easier on electronics and they look nice.
You know, while we're at it, let's do an update to our findings and uses of LEDs. What are we doing with LEDs now?
We're using the non-ghosting premiums for controls.
We're changing
frosteds for GIs and
We're changing over our stock. We're finally moving from generation 2 to generation 3 bulbs.
You could call it third.
It was the Adams family out there that did it to us. It had 85 ghosts in it, and I gave up I jumped off my, what do you call that, the pedestal where I said we could find out the problem for all of them. It just ain't even worth it.
No, I think it's just new technology that doesn't combine with something not designed for them.
Sure.
And you're not going to fix what they're doing.
You know, that being said, Jimmy brought me up to speed. He tried the premiums on his Toten.
Did he?
Remember, he was having a really bad ghosting problem.
I saw it.
And it didn't fix his problem. I did fix some of his problem, but then it came down to a diode was on backwards somewhere, or you know, they won't solve if you've got a serious problem.
No, yeah. They'll only solve the design
slightly,
issue.
Yeah.
Not a problem. A diode on backwards?
Yeah.
Really?
Imagine that.
Wow. Okay.
Remember the Revenge from Mars, the diode that was on backwards on the Switch?
Yeah.
And that game never worked right ever?
Yeah. Factory.
Wow.
You found out?
That took me a day and a half to find.
How did you feel about it?
I felt some sort of way.
Yeah. I like my gun. Hey.
Okay, Ray, what are you doing over there?
I brought in the finish.
You painted the gun. You know you have about 2 weeks left to finish that game and one more of these.
Yes. What's that mean?
That means that this tech tip's going to have to be short so we can get some sleep and work on something else. Oh, you're not going to be around tomorrow. Okay, Ray. Your show. What are we doing?
I don't know. First, I would say you take the point door off. Or no, first I would say play field out.
Let's take the play field out.
That's going to get it out of the way of the side rail the removal, and that'll get it out of the way of the hardware and the plunger assembly, and then the coin door is easier than working across the play field. So that's what to do first, play field out.
I've got the camera on a stand because I figured I'll be helping you.
You're tired.
Yeah, I'm too tired to hold the camera. If you don't mark that taxi, I'll lose it.
I'm going to put it back.
It'll end up on checkpoint.
Okay. I just want to get this out of the way. And...
all right, I'll come off the stand for a little while. What do you do before you lift the playfield?
pinballs out.
Take the pinballs out, you know? There's some people that have been in this industry for years and years and years and years and years that don't know that yet.
This is funny. The only nice thing is...
Yeah, the lockdown board looks great. Let's take that back.
Doesn't that stand
Let's take that back out so Felix can do his proper paintwork in there. Speaking of those clowns, Ray, I need you to put some time into your schedule somehow. I have a Pirates of the Caribbean on the floor out there. How old is that machine? About 7 years old, six, 7 years old?
Yeah, so six, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, it's you know, 6 or 7 years old. It has maybe 400 or 500 plays on it. So what I need you to do is I need you to take out all of the circuit boards and reflow solder on all of them because that was recommended by somebody.
Well,
even on a new Stern with less than 500 plays on it.
Reflow solder?
I need you to do that.
Reflow solder.
Can you find time to do that? It's important.
I'm not any good doing that.
Okay, viewers. It's a post. Is that whole thing A, stupid? A, he's stupid. B, he's lying. Or C, both.
I don't know.
I'm going with C. It's both stupid and lying. He doesn't do what a pin needs, let alone stuff like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a new Stern. I'm going to tear out all the boards and reflow solder them. Did I show you that already? Where he said that? That was ridiculous.
I've heard it mentioned before.
On a new Stern, though?
No, not on a new Stern.
I'm waiting for him to take one out of the box and do it. Here we have a new out-of-the-box Stern. We're going to reflow solder on it. And put our quick connect the battery thing in there. Okay. What you doing?
I am unplugging things that go to the play field from the interconnect board.
Oh, yeah. We love interconnect boards.
And some of these go to cabinets, some go to play field, but all the ones on the interconnect board probably should come off to do this. And then there are a few others that have to come off.
You know, the first time that I looked at that section of a game, I was afraid to pull off anything as it looks like a big tangled mess of spaghetti. How can you tell what goes where?
That's generally keyed by location and size and connector dimension. And wire colors. I mean, standard colors are used in all machines, really, the older ones anyway. Green and white are switches, yellow and red are lamps.
Okay.
Okay, and flashers, so it's really kind of an easy thing.
And then, of course, Arcade Rust says have the book. So when all else fails, you can look at the book, and the book will tell you where the, it will tell you where the connector goes, right? Mm-hmm. Wire color will tell you, you know, one J19 or whatever. Are you putting that back in?
Yes. Want to take a break?
You leaving?
I had too much coffee.
Okay.
I changed your mind. This doesn't stay with me.
Take it out. Yeah. Well, I just want to take a break.
Let's see if I can find my screwdriver. Oh, I was kidding when I said that.
That's easy.
You done with this? You think we can identify this as being a taxi part later?
Yes.
think of the Invisiglass?
Invisiglass?
Because I saw this thing. Tell the people what this is.
It's a display anti-glare deflector, glare deflector.
It goes in there.
Right.
It looks corny as hell on the game.
Yeah, it's what somebody came up with.
Yeah, they were selling this for like 20, 30 bucks.
Mm-hmm. Sold a lot of them.
Yeah. How come we don't have any get-rich, quick, goofy schemes like that where we can make something for 3 cents and sell it for 30 bucks?
And sell 20,000 of them? I don't know about it. Just don't think
people keep telling us we need to sell our tech tip videos. Are you all clear to come out with that already?
I'm double checking. Yes, I think so.
Okay, here's a tip. When you go to remove your play field, don't do it by yourself. You agree with that, right?
Yeah, they're heavy.
Yeah.
Unless you...
You're either going to hurt yourself or hurt your game or hurt something.
Unless you know what to expect, that's all.
Yeah. Don't do it by yourself.
Yeah.
I don't think you're clear, by the way. I think you got... And there you are. There you are.
In a WPC, it would be more.
So did you eat a lot of turkey today?
Yeah, not a lot, just normal. Did you? I should have come over a minute.
Well, you know, I was kind of waiting for you to call me and you never did, and then I texted you a couple times and you didn't answer me.
I was upstairs using my phone to the truck.
Yeah.
You should just come over, I didn't know that.
I was working on that thing.
Yeah.
I worked today, all day, on that.
Ready?
Okay, where's the dumpster?
Okay, it's play field.
Here we have a play field. I don't have the camera.
You don't have it? I got it.
Yeah, we know what it looks like. It's a play field.
It is.
Was the camera watching? Because I'm not behind it. I was over there.
Was it on?
It is on.
Nice.
This may be our worst tech tips ever. People said they want to buy these.
Really?
I can't make that up.
Okay. Well, that's all right. Maybe it does show things that we just take for granted. Handy things. I don't know. I go about fixing things every day in people's homes, and I take it for granted. They love it when I'm done. So maybe. I don't know.
Okay. Where should we put that? The abyss?
Can't go back over here. I'm going to set this back here for now.
Yeah, it's not going to the abyss anyway. We got to work on that.
Right here, because it's close to over there.
Okay.
And then... Hey, that display is good, huh?
Sort of.
Little things.
It's got 3 burn marks in it.
No, they're not.
It's got 3 dark dots in it. I don't know what they are. I mean, they light.
Wow.
I don't understand it. But at any rate, right, this tech tips, or this whole playfield swap has actually morphed into a full restoration. So we're not doing playfield now. This thing is going to paint. So step one right now is to prep this cabinet to go to paint.
Correct way to prep it, yeah.
Because
and this is including anything that any painter is going to do. You want to prep it for them. You don't let them do it.
Our painter paints. He does
anybody's painter paints. You don't leave the guy to paint around things because they don't want to do that, and they will, but then it's going to look like they did that.
Yeah, and it's not their job to clean. Although you know Felix does, but. His talent and expertise is in painting, and I'm not paying him to wipe off dirt that I can wipe off, or take a coin door apart, or any other stuff. He's got enough paint work to do, and that's what I want him to do when he has our machines. So we're going to show you how we prep this machine for him, and we could probably get this done in one in one sitting.
Sure. Correct way to take flipper button, flipper cabinet buttons off, since these are like a Tinnerman nut.
A what a who?
These things. Is to take duckbills and go here and just spin it around, because you're dealing with plastic, metal nut, plastic onto wood, so you're not wanting to tighten this, and you don't. People think you get on this with a socket and tighten it, so they take all this apart. You don't.
What?
No. You use this to swing it around, and as soon as it's loose enough, then you can spin it off by hand.
Maybe.
Depending on
whether like
it's
little
dirty. And you want to put the flange.
Yeah, the first time I put one of those on, I put it on backwards.
You don't put it on this way. It's made to go this way.
Yeah.
It's a simple thing. They use this cheap nut because it's the only thing that really could thread onto a plastic, because that's really not a thread gauge. It's just knurled. That's, you won't put a nut on there. That's not coarse. It's not fine. It's this. it's not a thread.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do we need a box or something to put all this crap in?
Yeah. Yeah. What we do is bag it up.
Okay. I'm gonna park this. Get you a bag.
So you do that first, and that's how you take those off, so that you're not aggravated.
Keep talking, because you're entertaining.
Well,
no,
I'm just saying. When I put that back, now you saw it.
I have a box. Put it in a box.
Phillips screwdriver to get off the ball plunger housing. There's 3 10-32 screws to take it off. It's mostly applies to every machine that has a ball shooter. And you want to take the hardware out of the machine so that the painter does not lose it, because he doesn't have to track hardware.
You still over there? Are you talking to the camera?
Yes, I'm talking to myself.
All right. When you put your parts in the box, if you're like a company or something and you're doing more than one machine, you want to mark the box for what game it is.
Correct. I like that. Everything's high low A's. I still find it. I can't believe that little single player Bally had so many parts. There just couldn't have been. I find these plastic tubs.
They're all marked high low A's.
Yeah, they're all. I think it was just a joke, you guys.
It wasn't me. Like, I would do that.
Dude, it's like I found enough parts to build 10 of them.
Make it so I can't find parts for a game. That freaking guy.
I know, dude. That makes me laugh. That kind of stuff. And this guy was serious about this. I've not ever seen that. look at these things. And they're not tight. Oh, and this is neat. Check this out, mate. Look what's holding this in. Where did he get this?
What are you showing me here?
Well, this other carriage bolt. I don't know. I guess they had two to hold the lock. Bar in.
Oh my.
What is that? That's a...
That's some heavy... Oh, he held it in with a rubber?
Yeah, I know where that... That's an industrial part hardware thing. You don't need to save any of that unless you want.
I can save these carriage bolts and nuts and stuff.
Okay. They're kind of big. All right, well,
I'll put them on eBay. Wait till you see me sell the old flipper buttons.
Now you need to take the door off. And that is 3/8. And first you should take off the wiring plug, and that is dirty. Wow.
Are we going to change the lock on this? Put a lock on the right direction?
Yeah. Coin doors all plug in, generally, with...
Wow, that looks awful.
Yeah, that's a lot of coke and beer.
Yeah, that's not burnt. That's just... It looks like it's burnt initially, but it's not. That's just dirty.
If you spray that with soap, it would come off clean, but... Anyway, coin doors are all held on with four bolts. There were several coin doors made. Entropy, Coinco, and Hap doors. And there might have been another one in there. Thank Gottlieb did.
What kind of door is this? Do you know off the top of your head?
I think that's a Coinco door.
It looks like the common Williams door this era.
I think Coinco made it. Leave the top one in last so it doesn't fall
out while you're working on it.
Yeah. These are just common flange nuts. They don't have a washer. Although, generally there is a washer. Somebody probably had that door off. There's usually washers behind these because this will dig into the wood, you know. So I usually put a washer on here.
Okay.
Somebody must have had it off because this ground strap is supposed to meet the nut, and that's supposed to be a ground. They usually use the washer on it, but maybe not. These are just 1/4-20 carriage bolts. And then you just have one ground here.
On top.
It's still there.
Was it a screw?
Yes.
No, it's not. On top.
Looked like a screw. 1/4-20. Some of them aren't even here anymore. But that one there, it stayed there.
Okay. Door ready to come out?
Oh, yeah, unplug the interlock switch. I think it's a bookkeeping switch on these games. It didn't really shut any voltage off. It was just to reset if the batteries were low.
Okay.
Batteries, that's what this switch does.
Yeah, it wasn't a high voltage.
No, I think it's a bookkeeping reset switch. So anyway, just your last fastener off, and the coin door comes off, frame and all.
Something tells me it'll just hang there because it's stuck on with dirt.
Cool. And you can get a sampling of what the real color was.
Where'd my upside down key go? Fit in the head. Is that it?
Tools out. Some other hardware to get off. This lockdown bar housing going to be the next larger thing to get off. Over 20 fasteners, which are already done, polished, and 1/4-inch bolts.
Keeping the people entertained, I walked away.
Did you?
Yeah.
Yeah, losing stuff.
What are you doing? You taking the lock bar back out?
Yeah, you don't want to leave it on.
No.
Because the painter generally tries to paint in this area.
Yeah, take that off. Got an email from, from Felix in Frankfurt at the River Main in Germany. I got an email from Felix in Germany. Not our Felix, apparently a different Felix.
Okay.
Hi. End of last week, I noticed that Papa subscribed to your YouTube channel. Papa subscribed to us. What's that? Professional Amateur Pinball Association?
Mm-hmm.
They subscribed to us.
Okay.
So anyway, since then I have watched about a dozen of your great tech tips videos. I'm pretty much a newbie to this hobby. Boy, we get a few of those. Coming from maintaining an old, what is that? Citroen?
Citroen? A car?
A DS car.
Yeah, Citroen.
We don't have those.
Dude, you ever see one?
Nope.
They had air suspension.
We don't have those.
Do you remember them?
No.
Citroen.
Do you?
Yeah, I remember.
I've never seen one.
It's almost like a hatchback. 80s, 70s? It's air ride. It has airbags in it.
Okay. Well, at any rate,
Citroen.
He maintains one of those things.
Really? Wow. There was a few running around back in the 70s, 80s.
Okay.
They were imported. I think they're French.
At any rate, 4 weeks ago, I bought a Roadshow pinball at a reasonable price.
That's cool.
Where quite a few things can be improved. I studied manuals and how-to blogs in German and English alike, but what you two show in your videos is unparalleled and invaluable. Well, I might go with invaluable. It's like having the opportunity to be an intern with you two. An example that just comes to mind, that some lamp holders are actually designed to be bent over, to bend in order to exchange a bulb. Or what soldering a flipper coil looks like. Just all those simple things you two develop in your great dialogue. You have to hear and see all those things in order to gain some experience. Hopefully your experience making those videos is worthwhile so that you continue with your excellent work. Felix in Germany.
That's neat. Thank you, Felix.
Here, doesn't that make you feel better about being here Thanksgiving at whatever time it is?
11 o'clock now, Mike.
I think it's probably almost Black Friday.
11:05.
Oh, my.
I'm almost like a clock. Here, let me get this out of here. Yeah, oh, my.
Where are we at?
Well, we're now ready to take the side rails off.
Okay. We still got the start.
There's a couple more pieces of hardware to go. There's these. Which shouldn't be loose, but these hold the playfield in the game.
Yeah.
It's probably one of the biggest carriage bolts used. Do not lose the
pivot.
No, because that allows the playfield to sag down, and even though this is very thin, it makes a difference.
Yeah.
And the playfield will tilt, and when you raise it, it won't cleanly come out of the wood, and it'll scrape.
Make a mess.
Yeah, it makes a mess.
Don't lose your stuff. Look at this corny flipper arrangement.
They were experimenting here. The manufacturer was experimenting with...
Okay, well here, I'll show it and you explain it. I know what it is, but...
Yeah, well, they weren't sure at this point what they wanted to do with cabinet switches. They knew they wanted to get away from open leaf switches. But they weren't sure if they wanted to totally get away from them. So they were in the market. They used sub-mini micros in these newer games, these 80s games. But they didn't want to run high voltage through it because that wouldn't work. But they did lane change with it.
So the micro switch is
lane change.
Is lane change.
Yeah, they took it away from the flippers because it was too much of a nightmare when the flippers had a pack of two on the flipper end of strokes. It's a nightmare to deal with that. So they put it down here. They recently moved it back up and then down again.
Yeah.
Who knows? And right after this might have been a crossover machine where they got rid of leaf switches and went to micro switches here. And then they went back to leaf switches. Then they went to optos.
That looks corny to me.
They keep changing. But anyway. I don't think there was any right way or wrong way to comment on people when they redesigned games, whether it was Gottlieb, Bally, or Williams. I mean, I think they got a good deal on parts and whatever they used. Hey, we're going to this because this is the way to go.
Yeah.
No, it was the parts availability. I think the parts sales guy stopped by and said, hey, I got a sale on these switches. You want some?
Yeah,
give me 100 million of them. And then I'll use them in dumb places, and I'll make a little paddle and spot weld a flat thing on them. Yeah, okay. Did you get that?
I got that.
All right.
Now, are these available, Ray?
Yeah. If you're going to start doing this, peoples, what you're going to want to do is not do this.
Oh.
You're going to want to put everything in bags, like, all right, we done so many of these, you're
I look at a pile of parts and I know what to do.
Yeah, because you know where they go, what shape they are, how long they are. Like, all right, here, this long one goes on top because that's where the lockdown bar is and it needs to be thicker. You don't put the little one. That goes at the bottom and it's noticeably different.
So what are you suggesting they do here?
All right. All the fasteners, including the little ones that actually hold the lockdown bar on, all of the related coin door things should be put in a bag by themselves.
Marked lockdown.
Yeah, you can mark it or not, or you could just put it in the bag and remember what that came from. If you're new to it, I would mark it with a marker. Just put lockdown. Abbreviate it. And also then your flipper buttons you could put in a separate bag and instead of putting all the fasteners in one, because if you've not done enough of these, you're going to lose track of what goes where if you have some repetitive hardware. And the problem you're going to run into is lengths of hardware. Like, if you put this in the wrong place, it might interfere with something, and you'll have to maybe take a part back, and you'll have to do it twice. So,
I think your concept is the same as doing photos. Remember the Comet we did?
But bagging it.
Do you remember Comet?
If I haven't
done it. I bought that machine in pieces. It wasn't assembled. All right? The guy had a box full of baggies, and each baggie had, like, it'd have three star posts, a rubber, and three pieces of hardware, and this would be left slingshot. And it had 84 baggies with, I just dumped all that crap out. It was ridiculous. And of course, it was all junk anyway because I replaced it all right in the first place.
You're using it for reference, is all. When I did the Kings and Queens, and when I did the Travel Time, which ain't done yet, when I tore apart Spacewalk, I bagged all of it up separate because it made it easier for when I was redoing it. I didn't have to think so much. It's all
okay.
And I don't do them games that often. These here electronic things, these solid states, I know where they use, what they use. They're pretty easy to do that. But if you're doing this new, you might want to segregate some of this stuff.
Okay.
Them boxes you buy are neat. I like that. And you don't mark anything, and they just have been the yellow
things,
ones. They're great.
Yeah, you know, I've been using them very much.
Anymore. No, I know, but man, that's a good idea. That box there. You might need two of these for some games, but you can change the little dividers. You can make long and short pins out of it, and they lock.
I know what this is.
These are great.
Name that game. See, this is easy. This is a slam dunk here.
Yeah. Gottlieb, the Haunted House.
It's a Haunted House.
Haunted House.
How do we have Haunted House parts left over? There's a tilt.
There it is.
Yeah, I'm behind on filing my extra parts.
But anyway, these are great, man, because you can redo your thingy and you can make small and big bins. I like that. That was a good idea. I enjoyed putting the game together back together when you used those, because I did a few.
Okay.
I liked it. Like Centaur you had?
Harbor Freight. They're cheap.
That's neat. Yeah. I like that better than...
I just bought more, right? Did you see over there? I doubled up on my LED boxes.
Yeah.
And I got another... In fact, you got a use for this because I got one too many.
Look at this nifty box thing.
I think it was $6 or $7.
No, it has removable thingy bins.
Yeah.
That's cool.
How nice is that?
Cool. It is neat.
You got a use for that?
I like it.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Okay. Well, that's a grippy rubber handle. I can use that, thanks. I'm going to use it.
Okay.
I'm telling you.
Good.
Yeah. I'm going to put this over here so I can take it home.
I think it was like $6 or $7, Ray.
You're always in there.
I did the right thing. When I went in there, Ray.
I like your chair.
Whatever you do, I'm painting that for some girl. I don't ever get a cart. When you go into Harbor Freight, do not get a cart. It's like, go find what you went in there for.
Things fall into the cart on you?
Yeah, go find what you were looking for first, and then try to get out of there, and I was walking to the counter like this, right?
Yeah. So you should have had a cord.
No, if I'd had a cord, I'd have bought more junk I didn't need. All right. Front end looks done.
Now this will flop around for him, so take that off.
Yeah.
That's
just a matter of being polite.
Yes, that's right. It's a service prod rod.
Now, can you just throw this out? Because it ain't needed. You don't need it, right?
Yeah, I work on this stuff.
Yeah, no.
You gotta have that.
Okay. What you got next?
I think we should do rails.
Okay.
Okay.
Don't you believe in power tools around here anymore?
No.
I haven't taken those off one of these games recently. I gotta tell you, I don't really remember off the top of my head how.
It's probably glued on. The ground braiding off.
Why not?
Because it's just too much to deal with to put back on, and it doesn't interfere with paint work.
Okay.
And it's not necessary. These are 1132s, and they've got a retained lock ring on them. Maybe these aren't glued.
Be nice if they weren't.
I think they are on these old things. It has a lock washer that's retained in it.
If you're lucky.
So you take the front and back ones off. Check for nails, and there isn't any.
So you're telling me they're just going to fall off of there?
No.
Yeah.
They're glued plus bolted.
Need
the magic tool.
Well,
I like that.
Well, I want that. Yeah, well, this was in nicer shape. I think I got this at Harbor Freight,
it's
probably.
It's seen a lot of work.
Yeah, I got my whatever I paid for it. I got my money's worth out of it.
Putty knife is also good because it's thin.
This is a dealer's choice item.
Yeah.
Felix can paint around that. Can paint around the rails.
I don't like how that happens.
I don't either.
No. I've done a few that way to know, and I don't like it.
But it can be done.
Yeah, I don't like it.
I don't like it either, and I like to have the rails off so that I can refinish them.
Yeah.
Correct.
So there's two reasons for it, and by refinishing them,
yeah, it'll look...
Get rid of this.
Yeah, it'll look better.
Yeah.
Are these rails available new, this design?
Yeah, I got them back here, remember?
Okay, they're probably...
I don't have the long ones, though. I got the short ones, so maybe these are, but the ones that...
It seems like they come and go as to what's available and what isn't.
Yeah, I guess it's the tooling. They do it, and then they don't do it anymore. I don't think the glue's going to fight you too much on this, but these are thick, so you don't have to risk bending them too much, but...
Well, you want to...
You don't want to...
You want to be really patient here, because if you bend the rail...
Yeah, they're stiff enough that you won't get it back. You'll have a dimple there. You'll have a bump.
I wonder what would happen if we cooked that thing.
I don't know. I never tried it. I always took my...
You're right, though. It's giving us pretty good.
Oh, they're old. It's old.
Just be patient, and you won't mess up your rail.
This has the glue strip.
Went really well.
All the way up and down. Some of them only have sections of glue strip, like 6-inch strips. This one has it all the way up and down. And yeah, there's an old piece of literature that got mixed in there. That's cool. Must have been there when it was from the factory. It's neat. Anyway, this stuff peels off relatively
easy. Yeah, we'll clean that off. But that's a job for another day.
It's almost rubbery. And what's left is these. And these are stapled, but the staples are not deep. They're only 1/4 inch. They barely go through, and they do a poor job.
Okay. Yeah, we'll show them how to reinstall that someday.
Right. That's right. Those are the glass slides.
And are those available now?
I don't know. They might be. I don't
know. I've never bought them.
No.
But sometimes
they're broke on the ends.
Sometimes
we crack. Yeah, they hold the glass. People think that the playfield glass is retained by the solid metal rails, and it's not. The glass never touches those. It would shatter. It's totally enclosed in plastic, including the back drip edge. It's totally, and then in the front, it has a foam padding. So it's actually setting like in a framework, not against wood, not against metal. If you look close, every game has that.
Okay, Ray, we're going to take a break here because this camera's out of film. We'll cut here. We'll take a break. We'll do the other rail off camera and then come back.
Okay.
Be right back with you, folks.